We are looking at an ideological practice in the General Assembly of North Carolina whose goal it is to diminish the public institution of public education, starve it from the resources it needs to actually improve or to make the gains that our children deserve, to turn around then and say, look, I told you that public education isn't doing the job, so come with us on the private journey. And I think it is trying to create the story, fulfilling its own prophecy that it creates by its actions. I think that's a sad state of affairs because there's only one institution in the nation that's bonded our people together as one nation under one common set of values, and that's been public education. I think that this session is just a classic example of lots of money being poured into choice options, into voucher options, and hardly any being put back into public schools from which several billion dollars was taken over the last five sessions. It is hard to understand that philosophy when 90% of your students still go to public schools. And I think the other thing that is out there from the public is all of the taxpayer money that goes into public schools, whether we like it or not, in terms of the outcome, is accountable. We test everything. We look at all of the data, and we can see when schools are failing. We may not have been as responsive as a state when they have, but that's a whole different story than pouring hundreds of millions of dollars now into the private sector with no transparency, no accountability. And then when you get some sense of data that's showing that those students are not doing as well as students in public school, throwing the data and saying, oh, well, the data must be wrong.
I'm sure you've heard the arguments from the other side saying, well, they have actually increased funding for education. They've giving teachers a pay raise. They keep claiming that they are supporting public schools.
Well, it all depends on your definition, doesn't it? There is some truth, right, to the fact that additional money has been put in. Of course, if you fail to look at what's been taken out and netting it, or if you fail to look at it over time, that it changes the scenario. For example, there was teacher raises this year. They weren't what the legislature said they were. They were not nearly what the governor projected they were. But just as a simple sort of exercise, if you are looking and saying, I'm putting in money and paying teachers, and you're saying I'm basing it on anticipated teachers who are going to be there, you get one set of figures because that's based on all the teachers who exist this year. But we know that there are plenty of teachers who retire each year, and they're replaced by teachers who are much younger and paid much less. But if you fail to take that into account and look at that, it's skewing the data. The governor, in fact, had a plan that would have given teachers across the board a significantly higher raise, moved us closer, inched us closer to the national average. And it's not just teacher pay, right? It's been everything. It's been elimination of mentoring programs, elimination of professional development programs, which have just started to be put back, elimination of teaching fellows programs. We've put a teaching fellow loan program back in after we cut a nationally renowned teaching fellow scholarship. We've put the loan program back in for only STEM teachers and special ed teachers. Do people not think we need foreign language teachers in a global economy? Do people not think that we need people to teach reading in third grade? They've eliminated the capacity of teachers, future teachers, for career status. They've now eliminated the capacity in a few years for them to get health benefits when they retire. All of that adds up in a way that if you're a teacher and graduating from a teacher college in Pennsylvania, do you really want to come to North Carolina, or are you going to choose Virginia or Pennsylvania or another state that actually values its teachers at all levels? We have a long way to go to catch up to where this state was under Jim Hunt, and for that matter, in the beginning stages under Mike Easley before the recession. I always said that kids will learn if they have a competent, caring, dedicated professional in front of the classroom, and they won't if they don't. And we continue to not invest in our people and therefore create more hardship for our kids.